Yes, 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 yes. Yeah, bitch, man. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Pleasant. This fella here that live streaming, tell me I gotta stand up behind this thing here and talk to you. So what y'all say? No, man, y'all gotta catch me away moving. I talk it to the people. So I cannot say, I'm talking to you. Pleasant, Georgetown, Buxton, Barbies, Region 3. What are Region 3 people now? Make some noise!
Here it is.
Now, tonight is, as I say, it's a small meeting for the 18th AFC. If you check on the calendar of meetings, you will see meetings, several meetings all across the country. And then we got a big rally. That's the time the president and the big guns just come out. So this is a small little meeting. But look around and tell me what you see. Look around and tell me what you see. Is this a meeting or is that a rally? What is this? What is this? Let's ask you outdo yourself. Let's ask y'all overdo. But I am very happy for this turnout. Because this afternoon I came and I did a little walkabout in Pleasant. And I met a lot of people who had concerns to talk about this and talk about that.
Everything.
And everything. But what I say is that this government under David Arthur Granger, this government under a president who is honest, who is decent, and who has integrity, that this government delivers. And so when I went to Leonora, I saluted our president. And tonight, the people of Pleasant, I salute you. I salute you because you have stood the test of time. You have stood by the APNU and AFC through thick and thin, through good times and in bad, and you've always supported us. Before I came here, I had a look at what the results were in 2015. In 2015, this community had 5,061 persons who were eligible to vote. Of that amount, 3,725 persons came out to vote. And of that amount, the APNU AFC had 3,246. So they said that was 76.6% of the votes. But my dear brothers and sisters of Pleasant, I don't want 76.6%. We are looking for 100%. Can we get that from Pleasant? Listen, the world listening to y'all. So when I tell y'all I want to hear something, I want to hear vibration, I want the music, man, get on the good foot. Because the world is looking at us. Now tonight, people from all about came to this little meeting. We are have everybody's great support in this coalition. And so what has happened, that has drived fear in the heart of the PPP. When they look at these crowds, when they look at the response we are getting from people all across this country, they are shivering in their boots. The previous speakers told you about the bad things that the PPP did. I don't have time with them. And if I talk my mind, the ERC will cite me again. They're going to cite me again. Because they cite me for saying some things to you that I never said. They cited me for making some statements at Pleasance. And I ain't talked here since 2018. So how they going to cite me for saying something to the people at Pleasance? Is no way talking. So ERC, you could cite me again tonight because I am talking to the people of Pleasance.
Forward ever, backwards never.
Now, I want to narrow down this message because enough has been said about what our country has done, what our government has done, what our president has done, and what the ministers in that government has done. We have said enough about that. What I want to talk to you about is what we will do for you. What honest leadership can do for you. What honest leadership can provide. This afternoon, I went into a yard in Pleasance here. And I saw some young men, and I asked them to come to the meeting. They say, I want to know what this government do for young people. So I said to them, come to the meeting and I will address you. I will say to you what we are doing for the young people of this country. Anybody here from that group? Anybody here from that group? All right, well, they're probably listening to me in a little corner. But when we took over government, unemployment among our young people was at its highest. And as a government, we sat down and decided that we have to do something about young people and employment for our young people. In the previous administration, in fact, when the PNC was in power, the PNC set up the Ghana National Service. This was meant to create unemployment opportunities for young people. It was meant to train them, to put them into the workforce. But what happened? The PPP came into office and they mashed it up. And so President Granger said, y'all break up the National Service. I can build back the Ghana Youth Corps.
Forward ever, backwards never.
And so in 2018, the president set up the Ghana Youth Corps. This Ghana Youth Corps trains our young people with life skills. It prepares them for the world of work, and it allows them to be able to get training so that they can employ other young people. So that when we're talking about what we're doing for young people, I will say to some of you, when you get the opportunity and you go up the highway, look at where you used to have Kurukuru Cooperative College. They got the road down right inside there. And that entire college has been transformed for training for our young people.
Forward ever, backwards never.
And that is not an easy task. We were doing all of this even before oil came into Guyana. We were doing this with the resources which we had available to us from all of the other sources that you can have to develop your country. So we didn't have to wait on oil to recognize that our young people needed employment and that we needed to prepare our young people for this decade of development that we're talking about. And I can say to you as well that apart from the Ghana Youth Corps, that the Board of Industrial Training has over the last 3 years or so, hundreds of people
In fact, over the last 2 or 3 days, they graduate 130-something persons in basic skills. So we must not fall for this PBB propaganda that y'all ain't doing nothing for we. Everything that you do takes time. We understand that you are impatient because you've waited for 23 years before we came into office.
Forward ever, backwards never.
And you are anxious to get development. So we understand that. And we don't argue with you because you are impatient. We understand this is what youth is all about. And so we work with you. We will work with you. So to those young men who were talking to me this afternoon about what you're doing for the young people, I say to you, your future is secured. Your future is secured under the AP and new AFC administration.
Forward ever, backwards never.
In previous times, you were a most insecure bunch of people, particularly the black youths. And Pleasant suffered significantly from that. Pleasant suffered significantly. Aubrey told you about their attempts to shut down this Guinness bar every Thursday night in Lima out there. And every Thursday night I had to call the police, what are you doing? What are you doing? And they insisted on doing that because this was a place where people exhale. They take all the stress and sun all week and they come out there in their own small way and exhale. But while they were doing that, some of the businesses that were aligned to the PPP were allowed to open up to 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, how long they want. All of them were doing that. And so you have to understand that this is a struggle for your survival. These elections are no ordinary elections. We have started a movement in 2015, and we will continue with that movement after March the 2nd, 2020.
Forward ever, backwards never.
We said that our motto is moving forward together. And we have taken that very seriously. So we are moving all of Guyana. We are not just moving one set of people. We're not just using the rich, the wealthy. We're not just moving the poor and the powerless. We are moving everybody. So all of the fellas who are liming, the fellas at the Guinness Bar, the fellas in Georgetown and other places, who the PPP believe they can buy, I'm saying this to you, that we are aware in the government of all of these attempts and these efforts to buy you. And I trust that the ERC don't take this as any racial statement, but it is a fact. It is a fact. Up to this afternoon, some of the young men I met told me that they wanted to buy all of these young people out and convert them into criminal gangs. This is what they're doing because they can see this green and yellow wave that's taken all across this country. That is something that they can't stop.
Forward ever, backwards never.
It is a train that has left the station. And so I'm saying to you, Pleasants, I'm saying to you, all of Guyana, that the only choice that you have on March the 2nd is to vote APNU, AFC, and to put back David Granger into office and allow him to select the cabinet of his choice.
Forward ever, backwards never.
Let me also say to you, because you've come from very long places, very far places for this meeting, that we love you. And that as a government, we will do what is necessary for you. Many of you complained last year when we were doing our walkabouts about the bridge at the back in this street going along to the end. Sparring Dam, right? You complained about it. And many people said, they're not voting if we don't fix that bridge. They're not voting if we don't fix the bridge. I said to them, as a government, give us up to December of 2018. That was August. I said, give us up to December. And before the end of December, they had a bridge.
Forward ever, backwards never.
And the bridge, I call it the Coalition Bridge. Because when you go across there, you see the green and the yellow, lovely. So the people over there went across the bridge, you can't come and tell me now, I ain't voting because I ain't got a bridge. Right? Promise delivered, number one. Secondly, there are some people that had a nice little grung in here in this community. Sparnam grung. The previous administration, they had a contract for about $7.5 million to fix that grung. And what did they do? They throw some mud on the ground, push it up in a corner, and left it so. So when we came there in August, the boys there, they were just playing on this little piece that was left. I said to them, this administration of President Granger will fix that ground for you. They said, we got to get it before elections. I said, all right, you can get it before elections. This afternoon, is that election yet? This afternoon, I was able to go on that ground. It's lovely fence. It got washroom for male, washroom for female. It got stands up and anything built. And the young boys are playing on the ground.
Forward ever, backwards never.
Pleasant, so you can start the progress.
Forward ever, backwards never.
Pleasant. Pleasance Community Center ground. What about that? We fixed all of that. We fixed all of that. So what I'm saying to you is that we are a government that we make a promise and we keep it. So Pleasance, you ain't got no reason but tell me now, you're not coming out and vote. You have to come out and vote. Your future depends on it.
Never.
Your future depends on it. Our future depends on it. So when you go out on March the 2nd and you go to vote, AP and UAFC looking for the palm and the key, and you put the X to the top, you look for the palm and the key, you put the X to the bottom. And that is your duty. That is your duty, Pleasance. Because let me say another thing to you. Some people believe that they start talking, oh, look at these rallies, nice and big, we done win. We ain't done win yet. Rallies is not proof that we win. Rallies is proof that we popular and that we got the support on the ground. But you now have to convert that popularity and that support into the actual votes that you're actually going to put there in the ballot boxes. So, my dear brothers and sisters, this is, in my view, a very simple task that we have to do. We have to convert this enthusiasm into real votes. And Pleasance, I know you can do it. Pleasance, I know you can do it. Pleasance, I know you can do it. Pleasance, make some noise to me now.
Backwards never.
Pleasance, make some noise now. I go for ourselves, stand up, take a little sweat up. You know, in classes, we just tell you up and down, up and down. But I want to say that tonight is a very special night for me here in Pleasance. Because I came and the team of the APNU came and your people responded. They responded in numbers that many persons never expected. That they will see this kind of number here in Pleasance at the line top. So I want to say to you that the AP and the AFC, that we are thankful for this. We are happy for this. And we are looking forward to you converting this enthusiasm into actual votes so that we can win these elections. And like Mr. Williams said, and Aubrey Norton said, by a large majority.
Forward ever, backwards never.
This is not about a one seat. It's not about a one seat. Now, today, in Toronto, they had a little rally where the people of Toronto, like the people in New York, like the people in New Jersey, came out to support and show their support for the APNU-AFC. And there I had to send a message like many other people sent messages. And I sent a message also to Mr. Charan Das, who is in some apartment or some basement in Canada, sending texts and WhatsApp and tweet and all these kind of things. He's probably can't even come out on your own like we here and have a good lime. Go by the corner shop, then nap a good beer. He can't do that. But these are the people who damage our democracy. These are the people who take our democracy for granted and believe that he alone can pick up himself and go vote with the other side. Well, we are putting arrangements in place so that can't happen again.
No more.
It can't happen again. So our president has said that we are looking for at least 35 or 36 seats. Now, that is the president's minimum number. As the campaign co-manager, my other co-manager, Mr. Rafael Trotman, we said that is the minimum. We are aiming for at least 40 or 45 or thereabouts.
Forward ever! Backwards never!
So, Plaisance, we need from you 100%. We cannot take a chance. This government that we are in now, we are in this government by not by one seat, by one vote. That's how thin it came down to. We won a seat in the Mazaruni Kayuni by one vote. And if you got one seat, then you could understand what happened. So do not take things for granted. Every vote counts. Every vote counts. So don't take no chance. Don't let nobody tell you they're feeling good or they're belly hurting them and all of that. Bring them out, lift them up, carry them to the polling place and let them vote. Everybody got to come out. This is a duty which you owe to your community. This is a duty which you owe to your children. This is a duty which you owe to those old people who toil and sweat to bring us where we are today. And so this duty, I'm asking you to take it very seriously and ensure that when you go out there on the 2nd of March, that you vote solidly, you vote with dignity, and you vote for honesty, you vote for integrity, vote for decency. That's what I'm asking you to do.
Backwards never!
So, Plaisance, tonight, again, I salute you. Tonight again, I say to you, irrespective of where you are in this community, that we pride your vote. We look forward to your vote. We expect your vote. That you are going to ensure that President Granger, as Basil said, is re-elected. Well, Basil, you know, Basil, know the legal thing and so on. But I say, keep Granger in office. My neighbor rejected because we're going to move smoothly and seamlessly from the 1st of March to the 2nd of March to the 3rd of March, and we're going forward like that.
Forward ever! Backwards never!
So the rest of it is just process. It's just process. You got to sway and all kind of things. It is just process, but the action taking place now. And so I'm asking you, people of Plaisance, protect your votes. Do not allow people to come into your community and tell you a lot of stupidness. Tell you a lot of nonsense that what are these people doing for we? What are they doing for me? We have done quite a lot. But we are not a boasting people, and maybe that's one of our failures, that we have done so much, and we haven't taken the credit for it, so that people take us for granted. So now that we're rolling out all these projects that we do, people say, what are this thing happening here in Guyana? But it's been happening all the time. But we are not boastful. We do our work, and we do our work in peace, in dignity, and quietly. And we do the work that is necessary for the people of this country. We are not here to do anything else other than to serve you. We are your servants. That is what we do. As a government, you elect us to serve you. And over the last 4.5 years, you have had a high quality of service. Isn't that so pleasant?
Pleasant.
We are depending on you. President Granger is depending on you. The APNU AFC is depending on you. And so let me clear up another little thing here that Mr. Frederick is soon right in his stupidness. Write and say that me, Joseph Harmon, cause camera from Jatan. How could I do that? I said, and I will say again, that Kemraj is our we own. This was said. Kemraj is we own. Just like the president is our own. All of these ministers who serve in the government is we own. So I don't know who could write Frederick Kasun and tell you, I said, and put it off in the stars and stripes and off anything next to I say. David Patterson is right here. He was there at a meeting when I said it, that Ramjetan is we own. At a meeting in Moka, I said Ramjetan Nagabutu is we own. And all these people is we own. The APNU and AFC is a tight coalition. And they're trying to break us up. They're trying to break us up by all kind of slander in the newspaper, on the television. Every day they're slandering us. They're trying to break us up, but they can't do it. You know why? Our president, David Granger, has said, we are better together. And tell the world, we are better together. And so this coalition, when you go to vote, you remember that this coalition is the best thing for happen for Guyana. This coalition. That many people in the world, they said a coalition don't last long. Coalition has broke up in a couple years. President Granger has shown the world that a coalition of 6 parties can work. And he made it work. And we're going to work again after 2020, March 2nd. And we're going to work again right through. You see this coalition here? It ain't breaking up. Like tell you all this. If I pledge myself to honor always the flag of Guyana, I will work assiduously to make sure that this coalition stays in place.
Forward ever, backwards never.
Pleasance, people, y'all understand that? So don't let no one party come here and tell you they can run things. The PPP is so into itself. That they drop out the C out of the PPPC a long time ago. They drop it off. So you're all hearing this PPP, PPP, PPP. Now all of a sudden, up come Mark Phillips and a couple other people, the small C start emerging again. But there is no C. It's only the PPP, that's what it is. And so you understand that it's not just about one party also. It's about one man. One man believed that we say he got the transport for Guyana. So he could do what he wants, sell what he wants, and do what he wants to anybody. It is not going to happen. We have gone past one party rule. We have gone into coalition mode. And we will work to keep this coalition, my brothers and sisters. We got to work to keep it. And it is all for you, for the people of this country, for the benefit of the people of this country. We will work to ensure that your quality of life is improved. We can't do everything all the time right away. But the good life, The good life means different things to different people. So we are going to do what is right by you. We are going to work for you as a government. We are going to work for you as a coalition. And all we ask of you is that on March 2nd, when you go to the polling place, that you remember what we have done. I don't even ask you to remember the PPP, because as far as I'm concerned, they are history. They're already in the garbage bag. They're already dumped in the history. They are history of Guyana, not in the future. The future of Guyana is about green and yellow. And many people believe that we invent this green and yellow thing. If you check the national anthem of Guyana, we didn't write it. What did it say? Green land of Guyana, our heroes of yore, both bondsmen and free lady, bones on your shores. Green land of Guyana. Not any other color. So that these green and yellow represents something that is dear to us as Guyanese. Something that is dear to us no matter where we are. And I know people are looking at us all around the world. In Abu Dhabi, all over, people sending me things, say, I'm watching at y'all. The world is watching. And so while the world is watching, we have to perform. We have to show them that we are a united people, that nobody can break we up. In fact, every day we are welcoming people. We are welcoming people, and our numbers are soaring. If there's one question that I've been asked on this campaign more than any other question is, where my green jersey, where my yellow jersey there?
Forward ever, backwards never.
You saw tonight when the noble princess was, the royalty was there on the stage. She said, I got some jerseys. And before you know it, all these chairs nearly broke up. Right? So, we are going to give you, and we're not selling you these things, we're not asking you to collect a 10,000 and wear a jersey. People are coming and they're asking for it voluntarily because they want to be identified with the way Guyana is moving. They want to be identified with the progress that has been made in this country. And so I say to you, you are part of a great movement, Plaisance. I say to you, all of Guyana, that we are moving forward together. We are moving Guyana forward. And we will move Guyana forward after the 2nd of March when we go into the polling booth and then the results are declared that David Granger and the APNU-AFC, that they have been declared the winners of these elections. Good night, Plaisance. Thank you very much, Plaisance.
Na 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 na.
Don't stop the progress, Plaisance. Let's go.